One morning, a woman came to my office and her son had been recruited to violent extremism. And that morning, the son woke up in the morning and told the mother, I am going to Somalia. I am going to join the Al-Shabaab. And the woman came to me crying. And she asked, what can I do? I love my son, he's the only son. And he has boldly told me he's leaving. And so I had to think through and I decided to go and have a chat with the son. The experience and the skills that I've gained over time doing my work, I went and I invited him for a cup of coffee and we started to chat. And that he was supposed to travel that night to Somalia. But he said, yes, he will come. And so he came to my office. And just spent that the day with him. I bought them for lunch. So that day he didn't travel again. I did a program over almost a week to ask him if he could come, we continue chatting. And I was able to show him how beautiful Kenya is. Talked to him about the future, he had a young wife. Talked to him about his wife, positive things. And by the time I picked up in the morning, he was a different man. So I delivered him to his mother, and his mother just started screaming all over. She didn't believe that this guy is talking about religion, he's talking about government. He's talking about volunteering around, and he forgot the story of going back to Al-Shabaab. And that youth today is one of our champions. He's the one who actually runs our youth programs. And that really makes me feel that was something I made a huge contribution in that one person's life.
Community-based organizations are best to prevent and counter violent extremism, because even after a project has ended, our lives within the community don't end. We know people. We know people who left to go and join these violent extremist groups. How do we know them? Because our neighbors, neighbors to our neighbors, are people we went to school with. When it comes to violent extremism, the recruiters are in the community. The sympathizers are in the community. For us to be real practitioners and to have those key results, you need very credible voices within that community. Why? Look at the recruiters. Who are they? They're also people, credible voices. So you need somebody who's at par with them, somebody who can stand toe to toe, eye to eye with them, and encounter all the narratives and the messages that they bring up.
The Global Center has a unique way of working with partners and with organizations that they work with. They look at your work, they talk about your work with you. So I like that concept of collaboration where each person has a voice in the decision. Other people tell you what to do. The Global Center discuss with you what they think we should do as partners. As a local organization, we have a network of reach. The international organizations will have their own network of reach too. Maybe fundraising, networking, donor partnership, capacity building, they bring that to bear. So we are the eyes of the project on the ground, and they become our eyes internationally in exposing what we do and getting people to understand that these are the kind of people that we're working with, these are the type of support and help that they need. These people are doing, you know, that they are amazing. All they want is an opportunity. And I'm just hoping that we'll have other opportunities to help a lot more organizations in the future.
Seeing communities, you know, moving from poverty to situations that they're able to feed their families, seeing women and girls being able to raise their voices, seeing communities engaging with government, and seeing government becoming more responsive to community needs, that really makes me very happy and gives me the motivation to work even more.